In order to publish your website in EverWeb, you must have purchased the standalone license or have a hosting account with Rage Web Hosting. This may also be known as an EverWeb hosting account. You will be required to log in order to publish your site. There are three ways to do this. The first way is to open up EverWeb's preference window and log in with your email address and password. This is the same email address and password used when purchasing EverWeb. The second way of logging in is to click on the Publish button in the toolbar. A pop-up window will appear, and you will be able to click on the Sign In button to enter your email address and password. The third way of logging in is to click on your website name to be taken to the Site Publishing Settings window, where you can click on the Sign In button and sign in with your email address and password. Once you are signed in to your EverWeb account, you will be signed in until you sign yourself out. Under the Publishing heading, you can choose to publish to your EverWeb hosting account, to a local folder, or to FTP. If you own the standalone license, you will only be able to publish to a local folder and to FTP. To publish to a local folder, you can choose the location of the local folder by clicking on the Choose button and then selecting the location. You can now click the Publish button in the toolbar to publish your site. If you are publishing to your EverWeb hosting account, you will see the EverWeb location settings. Under Accounts, you can choose which EverWeb hosting account you wish to publish to. Most of you will only have one account, so you can leave this as is. If you have more than one domain on the account, you will see a Domains drop-down menu, which will allow you to choose which domain to publish to. If you only have one domain, you will not see this menu. The Subdirectory field allows you to publish your website to a different location on your server. This is mostly used for testing purposes. So, for example, let's say I wanted to publish my website to test out, but I did not want to overwrite my existing website, I can enter some text into the subdirectory field. For this example, I will enter the word temporary. What this now does is allows me to access my website at everwebtutorials.com/temporary rather than just at everwebtutorials.com. The current website published at everwebtutorials.com has not been overwritten, and nothing has changed since the last time I published my site. Remember, this field is optional, so if you want your site to be accessed at the root of your domain, then do not enter anything in this field. You can publish your website directly to your FTP server if you host your website with a third-party web host. You will need to enter your server address, username, password, and directory path if applicable. You will also need to change the protocol and the port if that is what your web host has instructed you to do. You can also enter your website URL. The information that gets keyed into these fields will differ for every user. This information is personal and private, and we do not have access to it. If you do not know what to enter into these fields, you must contact your web host to find out. If you are having difficulty publishing your website using the Publish to FTP server method, you will need to contact your web host to find out if you are entering your FTP information correctly. Whenever you are ready, click on the Publish button in the toolbar, and EverWeb will publish your website. If you ever want to publish your entire website and not just the changes, you can go to File in the menu bar and select Publish Entire Site.